Students, now let us look at the planning horizons for logistics. There are three basic planning horizons, which are similar to the management one, which are strategic, tactical, as well as operational. So let us look at it in detail, that what we will be looking at from the perspective of logistics. If you see this diagram, we have a strategic decision making. That strategic decision making is mainly concerned with the customer service, the channel of distribution, the supply points, where it should be located, and what would be the channel of distribution. For example, whether you are taking a wholesaler as part of your distribution, or you are taking only the end retailers as a part of your distribution, or are there some distributing company involved in it. Ye decisions jo hain wo strategic decisions ke andar aapke paas aayenge. Then we have the production locations, where the manufacturing facilities would be located. Again, a long-term or strategic decision. Of course, strategic decisions, if you can remember, the decisions which will have the impact for more than a year. Of course, ye wo decisions hain jo aapki supply chain network aur aapke network design mein bhi bahut important hai. We will be looking at the logistical networks in the coming sessions as well. Then there is a depot configuration. Depot configuration means where would you locate your warehouses, where would you locate your, for example, terminals, where would you locate your, let's say, cross-docks in case of Walmart or some other companies if they are using such type of warehouses. Then the depot type and number, kaun sa hoga depot, yani warehouse kaisa hoga, and how many numbers do you require of some specific warehouse. For example, Walmart would use 6 different type of cross-docks, 6 different working unki jo hai wo defined, and they would have distributed it in their network as per their demand, as per their supply. Uski base par determine kiya gaya hai ki kaun sa cross dock kahan par use karna hai. Location and size of depot, of course. Then transportation model choice. Then you would have a third party or on account. Aapke paas third party logistics bhi involve ho sakti hai. Direct delivery mode bhi ho sakta hai. Direct delivery mode, let's say for Dell would ship the customized laptops directly to the end customer. Then stock levels are there. Stock levels, how much stock or inventory you should have with you. All of these things. That means you would be determining your stock levels for a long-term period. Wo short-term nahi honge. Then comes the tactical decisions. Of course, the decisions which would have an impact would be less than a year. Normally, 6 months, 8 months ke jo hai, wo inke impact, in decisions ke impact hai. It covers your transportation, your vehicle type. Kis kisam ki vehicle type hogi? For example, whether you would be using a 40-foot truck, or you would be using a 50-foot container, or a truck jo usko leke ja sake, or you would be using the combination of truck and trailer for the movement of your carriage from one city to another city. Tactical decisions hai. Then you would have the contract hire kind of a negotiation. Contract karna hai aapne, ya for that period of time you would hire some trucks for it. These type of decisions. The primary routing, route kya hoga aapke paas uska. The delivery schedules, you have to meet your delivery schedules, and these delivery schedules would be, of course, less than a year, yani 4 ya 5 mahine ki deliveries jo hai wo aapke paas maujood hai. To uske liye jo delivery schedules hai, tactical decision, logistics ke point of view se. The driver's resources, how many drivers do you have in terms of transportation, if it is owned by you. Support facility, your depot storage, what type of storage you can do in your warehouses. Do you have the permission, or do you have the luxury or license to store the hazardous materials would be there. Kya rakh sakte hain, for how ye depend karta hai aapki depot storage ke upar. Of course, a tactical decision. design and layout of your different facilities like manufacturing facility, your warehousing facility, uska jo design hai, the design and layout, layout setting jo uski hai, that is the part of your tactical decision making. Of course, you can change the layout of your manufacturing facility in a shorter period of time as well. Then you have space allocation, you have storage media, handling methods, forklift lift truck types, and the numbers of it, whether you are using the forklift truck, do you require such kind of forklift trucks, then, and then if you require, then what would be the number as per the demand, unit loads, administration or information related things would be in the tactical decision making as well, information system support, monitoring procedures, stock location and control, order processing and documentation. Then comes the operational level. At the operational level, you will be looking at the decisions which are like 1 week, 1 day, or at most, let's say 15 days. Aapke paas isse zyada bada jo hai, wo time span un decisions ke impact ka nahi hoga. For example, good receipts and checking. Goods ko receive kiya hai, unko check kiya hai. Foreign impact hai aise decision ka. Whether you need to receive it or whether you are, the quantity is short, so you are giving your, let's say, supplier the notification that, okay, there is a less quantity. Maine ek document issue kar diya, wo document hum detail mein dekh lenge aage chalke, ki okay, there is a short quantity in which you have shipped. Ya uske andar damage jo hai wo maujood tha. Bulk storage, whether you are going for a bulk storage, order picking, aapki warehousing mein order picking strategy kis tarah ki hai, stock replenishment, order marshalling, order ko aap kis tarah move karwate hain apni manufacturing mein, load scheduling, returns, how would you look at the returns, on returns ki policy kya define ki hui hai, wo policy ki base par how would you act, then the personnel availability, aapke paas kis tarah ki human resource maujood hai, the stock update as well as the documentation completion, of vehicle maintenance, vehicle workshop activities, all of these activities would be a part of your operational activities. So we have seen that in logistics, the span would be from strategic to operational. Yes, importance is there for all the three decision making in or the planning horizons in logistics, but they have to be dealt either in isolation or there is some interdependency. Most of the time they are interdependent decision. Lekin you will first take your strategic decisions, logistic network, how would you, what are your inventory policies, all of these things would be coming under your strategic logistic decisions. Then you will have the plan for your tactical decisions and what type of tactical decisions you would make and which would actually translate into the specific goals or objectives which are covered under operational decision making. Thank you.